Change is the only constant, they say. It is said that the secret of change is to focus all of your energy, not to fight the old, but on building something new. All of us are here to build something new, an energy option which is a lot greener and sustainable. But it is also a fact that when mankind evolved from ethanol to fossil fuels like petrol and diesel, little was thought that it would accelerate social, economic, and technological growth to an extent where scientists predict that fossil fuels would not last long forever. We in the oil industry, for sure, are fully aware that fossil fuel usage and its availability would last for a few more generations, and there is no other fuel that can match its scale, convenience, established modes of distribution. Yet, when Mr. Avadesh Jha enthusiastically approached us to set up EV charging stations in Hyderabad, we felt the time has come and it would take that to change to a new energy source, and we supported his initiative. Nevertheless, this kind of energy options to changes are definitely needed to give an encouragement so that the younger generation feel motivated to switch an alternative green energy source. We are therefore agreed to the proposal of Fortum to set up charging stations at our retail outlets without considering much of financial returns. It is with a futuristic vision that Indian Oil has embarked on this electric charging vehicle journey at retail outlets. The success of this model here would dictate its scalability to other markets. This energy option has the potential to change the lifestyles of our consumers. On behalf of Indian Oil, I extend a hearty welcome to each and everyone here to witness lifestyle changes with the adoption of green energy option. Indian Oil, the energy of use Euro 6 compliant fuels in Delhi and NCR region, effective from 1st of April 2018, and the same will be made available to entire country by year 2020. The upgradation of fuel specifications from Euro 4 to Euro 6, a big jump, will ensure that clean fuel is available and by eliminating practically the sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide emissions in the air. Thus, we are ready to reduce the carbon emissions into the atmosphere. We are also providing other alternative energy, green energy fuels like CNG, auto fuel, auto LPG, and various options to the customers to adopt green energy options. Today, launching of EV charging station is a step further towards providing another alternative energy to the customers, making our retail outlets not just conventional fuel energy stations, but a true energy stations in true spirit. Let us take ours a vow that we fight pollution with the adoption of alternate energy options. Electrically charged vehicles is one option among them to really make the environment clean. Thank you very much, and a hearty welcome to you, and best wishes to all.
Information Technology, Electronics and Communications, Government of Telangana. Shri Sanjay Agarwal, Managing Director, Fortum India. Ms. Haley Antila, CTO, Fortum Corporate Office, Finland. Mr. Avdhesh Kumar Jha, Vice President, Charge and Drive and Sustainability, Fortum India. My colleague officials from Indian Oil and Fortum India. Esteemed channel partners, dealer friends, Indian Oil. Representatives from press and media, ladies and gentlemen. I'm extremely happy and honored to be present here amidst all of you for the inauguration of the first electric charging vehicle stations for general public. This is the first of its kind for Indian Oil and for the oil marketing companies in India. Indian Oil, in partnership with Fortum India, has made its footprint of having the nation's first electric vehicle charging station at the retail outlets to cater to the general public in Hyderabad. Transport accounts for about 30% of the global energy use. EVs, therefore, form a very crucial part of the renewable energy map. The International Energy Agency, IEA, and its Global Electric Vehicle Outlook report states that the number of electric and plug-in hybrid cars globally exceeds 3 million in 2017, a 54% increase as compared to the previous year. And amongst the different countries, China continues to be the dominant in the EV market, accounting for half of the total EVs sold globally last year, nearly 580,000 electric cars were sold in China in 2017, a 72% increase from the previous year. In US, which is the second highest, the total number of EVs sold were about, Norway accounts for 39% of the new car sales as EVs. In Iceland, new EV sales were about 12% of the total car sales, and their share in Sweden was 6%. Germany and Japan also saw strong growth in EV sales, with more than double in both countries from 2016 to 2017. Yet faster growth is needed for EVs to fulfill their role in the global energy transition. But through lowering vehicle emission and boosting renewable energy use, EVs is going to be a thing of future. This outlines the technological and policy advances still needed for EVs to help drive the transition to a sustainable global energy future. In India, Karnataka probably is the first state in India to have launched state EV policy in 2017, followed by Maharashtra in February this year. In March, UP government also launched the draft Uttar Pradesh Electric Vehicles Manufacturing Policy. And here in government of Telangana also is the process of coming out with the EV policy very soon. Worldwide, the conversion of transport mode to EVs is gearing up. EVs have a lot less moving parts than a conventional petrol or a diesel car, with just one moving part, which is the rotor. EVs are particularly very simple to maintain with less cost for running and maintenance. And EVs can also reduce the emission that contribute to the climate change and smog, improving public health and reducing ecological damage. Hope with the new EV policy coming from the state government side, the number of electric vehicles will see to improve in near future, both in domestic and consumer-based transport sectors, and Indian Oil is proud to be part of a cleaner and greener Hyderabad. I take this opportunity to convey my heartiest compliments to Mr. Ramana Rao from Indian Oil and Mr. Avdesh Jha from Fortum India, who spearheaded this execution. The teams have worked tirelessly to make this happen today. My compliments to each and every one of them involved in making this event a reality. Once again, congratulate all the minds involved in this initiative and thank each one of you for sparing time and making part of this event. Thank you very much.
We all wonder, and in fact, most of us keep wondering, that while a lot of song and dance is made about electric vehicle charging stations, we don't see them on the roads. We don't see them anywhere. And why such a big issue is being made about electric vehicles? The fact is that we haven't reached the tipping point as yet. And there is a whole amount of disruption which is just waiting to happen. For the disruption waiting to happen, I just want you to take you back to the past so you can figure out how the future would be. If we go back around 120 years, it was year 1900. At that point of time, 11% of the transportation was being done by cars. Cars had just recently come in. And 89% was done by horses. In just 20 years, from 1900 to 1920, the equation became reverse. So within 20 years, the horses reduced to 5% and the cars became 95%. And this is called disruption. And mind you, while this disruption was happening, you had roads which were being constructed, you had refineries which were being built, you had car factories which were being put up. All of those things were happening because everybody knew what the solution was. And above all, the World War I was also happening. So amongst all of this, a complete disruption took place because there was a technology advancement. I'll also give you one more example. In 1985, AT&T was the largest, biggest, world's largest landline telephony manufacturer. They had asked McKinsey to do a study that how many mobile phones would be required by year 2000. And guess what? McKinsey, after a lot of search, came out that 900,000 would be the mobile connections in the whole of the world by the year 2000. And instead of 900,000, it was 108 million. So when these changes take place, you never know what the future would be. And these disruptions are such that today we may not be observing it, but within 5 years, you would clearly find out how the whole world has changed. We are setting up solar plants, and we've seen in the last 6 years, the tariff have come down from 18 rupees to 2.5 rupees now. The same thing would happen with electric vehicles as well. Mr. Rahul Bhardwaj mentioned about how easy is the operation of an electric vehicle. Typically, it has been seen that the life cycle cost of operating an electric vehicle is practically 15x of that of a normal internal combustion engine. In a normal combustion engine, there are 2,000 moving parts as compared to just 8 moving parts in the case of electric vehicles. So electric vehicles would completely reshape how we see mobility. And we've not even touched the surface here, because as we would move forward, first the electric vehicles would come, and at some point of time, you will also have vehicle to the grid. Actually, there would be moving power sources on the road. So if you combine all of these things together, you don't see any electric vehicles predominantly on the road, but I can assure you, in the next 4 to 5 years, you would see a complete transition to electric vehicles. And it gives me great pleasure that electric vehicle infrastructure is an important element of the whole value chain and the whole of disruption. And I'm thankful to Indian Oil that they have given us an opportunity to tie up with them, to partner with them. And this is just the first step. As we've declared, we would put up 150 to 200 charging stations within this year, but we are not limited by 150 to 200. We are limited only by the vision and the future. If more electric vehicles would come, we would completely carpet bomb the whole of India with the charging stations. So it is just the beginning, and I can assure you all that this partnership, it starts off with Hyderabad, it starts off with these two charging stations, but it will go a long way in making the state of Telangana, Hyderabad in particular, to be EV compliant, and we would like to be a part of the journey. Thank you.
Excellency Ambassador Vaskunlati, Mr. Sanjay Agarwal, Mr. Bhardwaj, senior representatives from Indian Oil, Fortum India, invitees, ladies and gentlemen. This is indeed a very milestone day, in my opinion, when we see the launch of public charging facilities for electric vehicles by two of the strongest possible players in this area, Indian Oil from our side and Fortum from, which is a very important global player and one of the leading Finnish companies, which have created global benchmarks in their areas of activities. And so is the credibility and achievement of Indian Oil. It is one of our first Maharatnas. And for them to foray into this area, because it is also possible to feel a bit conservative about it, feel concerned that this will create an impact on your petrol and diesel business. But to realize that this is where the future is moving, and to be ahead of the curve, to invest in the future, is something really very appreciable, very foresighted. So congratulations to both the partners, and extremely thankful that you have chosen Hyderabad to bring this large-scale rollout for the first time in the country. I'm glad that you have seen all possible market signals, other signals emanating from public forums, that this is where the biggest action in EV front is going to happen. And as Mr. Agarwal mentioned, this is typically a chicken and egg kind of situation. When we ask people, why are you not investing in EVs? They mention that there are no charging infrastructure. And when we ask people to provide charging infrastructure, they say that there aren't enough vehicles on the road to justify investing in charging infrastructure. So one could have endlessly got caught in this chicken and egg debate. But I'm very happy that Fortum and Indian Oil have decided to bring an end to this kind of a needless debate and have invested wisely in this. I don't know whether you have put the chicken or the egg on the table. I presume you have put the chicken, and it will produce a large number of eggs in coming days. But right now also, the situation in Hyderabad is quite all right. We have close to 200 electric vehicles on the roads already, of which half of them are private vehicles, half are by aggregators like Ola has been the first to invest in EVs here. Zoom Car is another player which has EVs here. And Uber is likely to bring a fleet of EVs very, very shortly. But I'm very happy to share with you that we are in discussions with some of the biggest OEMs in the country. And the assessment that we have is that they are ready to bring 1,000 plus EVs to the city of Hyderabad in days to come. So this decision to have 50 charging stations, 100 charging points actually, because each location serves two charging points, is a decision which will very soon start justifying and will even start becoming a very major revenue earner. Similarly, you will be aware that under the FAME scheme, Government of India has also encouraged cities to set up, to provide public buses, transportation of public buses in the form of electric vehicles. So Hyderabad is, the RTC in Hyderabad is going to implement 40 EVs in the buses space. And in days to come, the Hyderabad Metro Rail is also signing up with a large number of last mile EV service providers. Many of these are very innovative providers. They have two-wheeler solutions, they have cycle solutions, they have non-motorized form of solutions also, which may not require batteries and charging, but there are battery-operated solutions also, which will definitely benefit from these charging points. We all know that, I remember the days, I was a student in Delhi. We had a major disruption at that time when the Supreme Court had directed that all the public transport in Delhi, the buses, auto rickshaws, will switch over to CNG. I used to be a student in Delhi in those days, and coincidentally, I used to live outside Indian Oil petrol. I mean, my house was opposite an Indian Oil petrol station, and when you would go to sleep in the night, you would realize that there are some 3-4 kilometers of queue of buses and auto rickshaws outside that petrol bunk. And then when you would wake up in the morning, you will see that the queue is still there. I mean, people are kind of moving, inching gradually. So obviously those days are gone behind. Lots of innovation has happened. Lots of new technology, new science has been introduced. And we would request both Indian Oil and Fortum to do some more R&D and innovation in terms of quicker and faster battery charging. What you have introduced today itself is quite impressive. A full battery can be charged in 45 minutes, and we saw live on the kind of ease of getting that transaction carried out. You don't have to be physically present, you can do that remotely. Electronic displays are happening, receipts are being generated and so on. But if you are willing to invest more in R&D and innovation in how faster modes of battery charging, there is also a concept of battery swapping. You must be aware that Sun Mobility has introduced this in India, and we are in discussions with them to bring that to Hyderabad also, so that you don't have to rely on just one battery. You can get a battery changed while your previous battery gets exhausted. So lots of things are happening, and it is also possible to do this kind of innovative work in Hyderabad, because some of you would be aware, Niti Aayog has recently announced the list of 6 lighthouse cities in the country, and Hyderabad is one of the 6 lighthouse cities which have been identified, which have been selected by Niti Aayog for EV-related work. So all of you would be aware that Pune, Bangalore, Bombay, Cochin, Vishakhapatnam, and Hyderabad are the 6 cities in the country under the lighthouse program. So let us make best use of that opportunity also. And since you are the first movers to set up charging infrastructure in Hyderabad, we will be willing to offer certain benefits also on behalf of the government, like a special power tariff for you, some GST benefit, SGST benefit for the power infrastructure, for the charging services, etc. So I would request you to meet my team separately and work out, looking at your investments and the numbers, etc., what kind of benefit you should validly get from the government. And we'll be very, very glad to extend that to you so that it motivates you to do more of this in our city. So as I said, this is indeed a very milestone day, a landmark day, and my congratulations to all the team members from both Indian Oil as well as Fortum for making this happen. And I'm very, very thankful that Ambassador Her Excellency has chosen to come to Hyderabad. This is again a very important achievement of Finland, because Fortum, as was announced, is a national company owned by the government, and deepens our partnership with between India and Finland. If and coincidentally, the Indian ambassador to Finland is also someone from Hyderabad, and she is paying us a visit next week. So when she is here, I'm planning to tell her about this particular intervention, and also plan such similar interventions in the areas of renewables, mobility, innovation, and other kind of public services, where Finland has shown its mettle, its excellence all this while. So thank you once again for inviting me, and best wishes to all of you.
Collaborated with Fortum to launch this first public charging station at one of our retail outlets, two of our retail outlets in Hyderabad. And now we have plans to expand this to 50, total 50 number of retail outlets here in Hyderabad itself. And for this, I really thank Fortum India for coming out and collaborating with Indian Oil and giving this technologically very advanced solution in terms of charging infrastructure for the people of Hyderabad. And we expect that now with these charging stations, there are a lot of electric vehicles also will start coming, because ultimately it will all depend on the users who are going to use this. And we have been in touch with many of the OEMs who are going to introduce many EVs here in Hyderabad, and I am sure that this is going to be a win-win situation both for Indian Oil Fortum as well as for the betterment of our environment and the new technology adoption that the Government of India is also promoting. We are taking this forward with this step, and definitely it is going to benefit all of us and to us as a society. So I think with this I should stop here, and then we can have further discussions or anything that you need. There have been few charging stations, but those are for captive use. Like I understand, one or two in Delhi, where NTPC have their for their own vehicles and all. For public use, this is the first station. It's for any company. I mean, for all the oil companies also. So Nagpur, we have introduced. In fact, Indian Oil has introduced, but that is specifically for Ola. So we had a tie-up with Ola, and those Ola cabs are getting charged there. So that's not for public use. So this is the first one with public use.
So this is the first EV station that has been launched in Hyderabad, and Indian Oil is very proud. And Indian Oil has joined with Fortum India, which is the EV service provider, EV charging service provider. And at two of our petrol stations, we have launched it today. And one petrol station is on Raj Bhavan Road, Gold Strike Fuel, and another one is company-owned petrol station on in Begumpet. So at both these places, we have installed one charger, and each charger has got 2 points. So with this, we will be able to start giving this EV charging facility to the vehicle owners, EV owners in Hyderabad, and we have plans to further expand it at 50 more fuel stations, a total 50 stations. So two are already now have been inaugurated today, and 48 more are in the pipeline. And based on the potential that would be available, we'll be very quickly now expanding this. And we are very happy that we are into this initiative. It is a green initiative where we are providing green energy, and we would like that more and more EVs, they get introduced, and the infrastructure has to come up. For that, we have taken this step to contribute from our side for the betterment of the environment. So the charging process is very simple. So you have these charging points which are available at our retail outlets, at our petrol stations, and the vehicles can come. Now these are what you call high-end technology, where you don't need any manual intervention. Everything can be done without any manual intervention. A person who's driving a EV, he can come there and he has to swipe a card. And that card, for that he has to first register with the Fortum, because this facility is provided by the Fortum. And then one can charge. You can simply put that socket. There's a socket provided. You can put it in your plug, which is there on the EV, and you can charge it, and automatically it will deduct the charge which is there, I mean, the in terms of the value that will be charged to your debit or credit card. So different options are there which Fortum is providing. So definitely now we are expecting that the introduction of electric vehicles in India is going to gather much more speed, and more companies are now coming out with the electric vehicles. So but considering the size of India and the size of size of the market, so many petrol vehicles are there, diesel vehicles are there. So introduction of EVs in India is not going to immediately catch up with the existing fuel vehicles. But I am sure because government is also promoting and people are also now conscious, they want to shift to electric vehicles, and I am sure it is going to be economical also in times to come. So there is a very good future for electric vehicles for electric vehicles in India. So Hyderabad, see, as I have already told you, 50 we have already identified. See, based on the potential and based on the information that we have gathered from the people who are manufacturing EVs, from them we have got information. So we expect that very soon, or maybe in next few months time, there will be a lot of new EVs coming into Hyderabad. And obviously if those vehicles come, to provide them charging station. So as of now, based on our study, we have identified these 50 stations. So 50, and each station will have two charging points, so 100 charging points will be available in Hyderabad. And if the demand grows, actually this is a growing market, and once we also see that the demand is growing, we can try to expand it further also. See, that part probably Fortum only can share, because they are the people we are providing them the space at our petrol stations. So that part of billing and everything, that is with the Fortum that they are taking. And I think they have announced that till 15th of August there will not be any charge, and thereafter it is going to be much less as compared to fuel per kilometer basis. If you consider, that is what our CEO of managing director of Mr. Agarwal of Fortum, he was saying. So I understand it is going to be cheaper as compared to other fuels. As of now in Hyderabad, this is just the beginning. We are in discussions with Fortum also. We might